Let's go. Three steps to more Friday morning confidence. And it all begins here. It begins in the place of alcohol freeness. The irony, isn't it? Like, because we would all turn to alcohol. What for? Confidence. We needed a bit of a confidence boost. I know what I'll do. I'll have a couple of drinks. We've got that big talk or that big speech at the wedding, right? And then we all get sucked into that same game. Who's been here? Right, you've got a speech to deliver at a wedding, for example, right? And you know you've got to just get it perfectly right. You've got to drink the perfect amount so that you've got that Dutch courage, but you're not slurring your words, right? Who's ever played that game? Who's ever played that game and got it horribly wrong? Who's ever seen that game played and go horribly wrong? We've all been to the wedding or the event and someone's played the just the right amount of drinks game and they've got it wrong. And then they turn up to deliver their speech and it's a dance floor disaster because they've overcooked it, slurring their words, forgetting what they're meant to be saying, saying stuff that they shouldn't. We've all seen it. And equally, people might get it wrong the other way. And then they're like, caught in the headlights of fear because they don't know what to say. And I've seen people stand up and go, literally read two words and then sit down. Right? And it's awful to watch. Their confidence is shot. Right? How does that work with this thing that's meant to give us more confidence when we drink it? It doesn't. It steals it. It takes it away. That's like the biggest thing that it does. It robs our confidence. It steals our real world confidence. It tricks us. Like, it makes us think we're more confident. And I tell you why it does. I'm not going to get into the neurochemistry of it because it'd be a bit bore off. But it basically dumbs your brain. And because it's dumb, because it's being smacked by all the toxins, you're like, oh, well, actually, I might as well just do this thing. You're not actually gaining real courage or confidence. And you know Dutch courage, where that saying comes from? The Dutch would drink alcohol before they went into battle, right? But in the sort of Navy terms, right, that was like really dismissed. That was a derogatory term because it was basically like saying you can only get stuck in when you've had a few drinks because you're weak, right? It wasn't how we sort of see it now. Right, it was a sign of weakness that they needed to have alcohol to fuel them into battle. Because it's true, because it's fake and it's pretend. It's not real confidence. It just dumbs you down. So you do, very often, we've all been there, really silly things. Who's done and said something really silly that you regret in a big way under the influence of that so-called wonderful courage and confidence that comes with alcohol? Who's done it? Let me know. Show hands. Let me see those hands on a Friday morning. Who's done it? All of us. Every single one of us has done something that we massively regret. We're like, I can't believe I did that. It wasn't real courage. It wasn't real confidence. We just did something stupid because our brains had been partially shut down. That's it. Yet there's this like association with alcohol and confidence. I know I've got a big confidence challenge. I'll have some alcohol. And what it's giving you on one hand, it's stealing on the other. So the number one thing, you want to talk about confidence, the number one thing. Well, I want to talk about confidence. You didn't suggest this topic, I did. But I want to talk about confidence because the number one thing that you can do for your confidence is not drink. It's the best thing you can possibly do, and I'll tell you why. Because what will happen in the early days, you'll feel like, I don't have confidence. And I'll tell you why you'll feel a little bit like you don't have confidence, because alcohol's bloody been robbing it off you for the last 20 years. And there is that, I've got to go back into social scenes, I've got to deal with this, I've got to do a talk, I've got to deal with this like big event, this trauma in my life without alcohol. And it's hard at first because alcohol's been robbing it. But here's the secret to this, the great secret to all of this. It starts to come back. It starts to build over time. You start to get this glorious confidence that was always there, just starts to make its way back. Doesn't mean things are not easy. Doesn't mean you're suddenly standing up in front of a crowd, delivering a speech without any fear. Of course that fear's there, but you're learning to manage it in a real way, in a way that's long lasting. This is the key. Alcohol is plastic confidence. It melts. It melts. The following day, it's gone. And when it melts, it takes a bit of you with it. But here's the difference. When you build confidence in your life without the booze, it stays there. It shows up the next day and the day after that, and it builds and builds and builds and builds momentum. Again, I'm not saying that you're the most confident person in the world because you've taken a break from alcohol, but you'll get your real confidence back, a different confidence. You can deal with everything that life throws at you without turning to alcohol, because you can deal with it. You've got a new confidence. Maybe you have to make that big speech at a wedding or an occasion, and you do it without alcohol, and you realize, I can do it, I did it, and everyone laughed, and I stuck to the script, and it went quite well. New confidence, lasting confidence. I'm growing stronger in the world. Just contrast that with the alcohol confidence. It gives you nothing. It's plastic, it's fake, it's gone. Whereas when you do stuff in the real world, you get lasting confidence. You want to boost your confidence? It's so simple. Number one, take a break from the booze. Number two, when it comes to confidence, confidence is a skill, right? Think about confidence as a skill that you can get better at. People don't think about it as a skill. They're like, you're either really confident or you're not. And here's another thing about confidence. Don't associate confidence with extroversion. I know so many people that are huge flamboyant extroverts that underneath it have the smallest confidence. They have no confidence. They crumble at the first like comment that puts them down or sets them back. And I equally know people that are very introverted that have a deep burning confidence in themselves. So don't confuse the two. It's very easily done. It's like, well, they must be really confident because they're really loud and outgoing versus the person that's a bit more introvert. Don't confuse the two, totally different things. Confidence is different, like it's something internal and strong. Whether you're loud or quiet, introvert, extrovert, doesn't matter, it's a different thing. So on that note, confidence is a skill that you can build. How do you build confidence? Do things that challenge your confidence. Put yourself in a position where you've got to deliver the talk, or you do a Facebook Live, or you do a post, or something that's going to challenge your confidence in the real world, and do more of it. That's why it's so important to get outside your comfort zone. What does your comfort zone do? If you're stuck in there, you don't need any confidence in your comfort zone. I'll tell you where you need confidence. Confidence when you step out of it. Come and train with me. Do some stuff, right? Take courses, read books. Get outside your comfort zone. Get in a room full of people. Turn up to something, an event, on your own. Challenge your confidence. It grows over time. It is a skill that you can build. All right, so take a break from alcohol. Challenge your confidence. And finally, which I love, my favorite tip, use your physiology to drive your psychology. And what I mean by that is, think about it. Like, we are so intertwined between our physiology and our psychology. If you stand and present with the right physiology, you send the right messages to your psychology. I'm confident, I've got this, I mean business. So you'll notice, if you ever watch me do a talk on stage, I'm constantly standing as strong as I can. There's a lovely lady called Amy Cuddy, who's done some brilliant research around this about the Superman pose, Wonder Woman pose. It makes perfect sense to me. What she did, she studied primates and realized that primates would use their physiology to build confidence before going into a battle or an altercation, for example. And equally, when they would win, they would use that confidence in their posture. So what she hypothesized, yes! Said that twice on a Friday morning without messing it up. What she hypothesized, oh, that was getting close. Three is too many, let's just stick with two. Anyway, that the humans would display the same, and we do. She researched it and we found that actually by standing strong, she calls it Superman pose, Wonder Woman pose, for 2 minutes in the mirror before a confidence challenge, guess what? Gives you more challenge, gives you more confidence. Why? I tell you why. Because it's sending the messages, right? Think about your central nervous system. It's talking to every bit of your brain and your body and your psychology and your physiology. And you're sending messages saying, I'm tall, I'm strong, I've got this. I'm not fearful, I'm not panicked, I'm not afraid. Whereas you can imagine if you find yourself in a situation, a big confidence challenge, and your body is talking to your brain saying, I'm fearful, I'm afraid, because it's crumbling in, and it's like, what message is that sending your psychology? Be fearful, be afraid, panic, get out. And that's when we freak the beat. But if we stand strong, we send those lovely messages to our brain to say, I've got this. I'm confident, I'm in control, and it settles down that primitive part of our brain, and then it gives you this wonderful confidence that you need to do the thing that it is you need to do. Isn't that beautiful? So those three things will transform your confidence, help you build long and lasting confidence. How beautiful is that? Take a break from the booze. Use the skill of confidence, right? And then use your physiology to build that confidence. Those three things will make a massive difference to your confidence in the real world. I hope that was helpful this morning.